In 1997, the Nashville Zoo opened its doors at Grassmere, a zoological garden and historic plantation located just 6 miles from downtown Nashville. Currently sitting on nearly 200 acres, the zoo features 339 species and has over 6,000 animals that each need their own individual care. Our media team recently had the opportunity to reconnect with nature by spending a day at the Nashville Zoo. We came face to face with the animals we all know and love and had a conversation with Heather Schwartz, the zoo's director of veterinary services, about all that goes into keeping these animals healthy and happy. Dr. Schwartz, thank you so much for sitting down with me today. I'm Kenzie. So we're gonna start out, why do you just come to work here at the Nashville Zoo every day?
So actually, conservation medicine led me into this job. I just love species and preserving wildlife and nature. And so it was just a marriage of the two of doing animal care, but also doing wildlife preservation, helping conserve species for the future. So I love the zoo and I love the direction in which it's going. And I love the amount of support the zoo gives animals around the globe to protect them.
Can you just go into more detail on like what the zoo's mission is?
Nashville Zoo and all zoos are here to conserve species and save them for future generations. Most people don't know what certain animals are, right? They don't know they exist around the world. You guys met a civet today, and people don't know what civets are and that they're located in Asia. Every species has a purpose here on the planet. Every species brings something to the ecosystem that's necessary, and so they're all important. So the zoos are here to show people that may never travel to Africa or to Asia or other parts of the world why those animals are important and we should care and protect them. We also want to protect things in our own backyard, like the Florida corals. There's a blight going through the corals. It's a disease that is taking over all of the corals south and east of Florida, which is just devastating for the ecosystem. And so zoos are acting as reservoirs for those species of coral to protect them so they don't get killed off by the disease until we can figure out how to stop it and how to prevent it. And so the plan is that the corals that we have here in Nashville will actually go back to the wild. And so we could really save a species from extinction by doing this. And we did that with a lot of species. Zoos have been heroes in conservation for the Andean condor you may have heard about, the Arabian oryx, black-footed ferrets, and just to name a few, these are species that did not exist in the wild and they were brought back from extinction.
Can you talk a little bit more about the conservation efforts that y'all are doing and all of the different animals that you guys help?
Yeah, there's so many. I mean, we try to put conservation first and foremost with everything we do, from our species that you see on zoo grounds to the work we're doing behind the scenes. So we do a lot. We do a lot of things local. So you may have seen our hellbenders, our alligator snapping turtles. So those are all things we're doing to protect species right in our own backyards. But then we also help animals all over the globe. So through International Rhino Foundation, breeding rhinos, but also giving a lot of conservation dollars back. We work with red pandas, clouded leopards, and we're always trying to take money that we earn from people walking in the gate, coming to see us, going to events. A percentage of that money is always going directly back to the wild to help protect the animals.
So a few years ago, you helped lay the foundation for the Nashville Zoo's the new veterinary center.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly what inspired you to expand?
When I first started working here in 2010, the zoo was much smaller, but as the zoo was growing and the collection size was growing, I knew that we were going to need more space. We really wanted something that we could expand our team and our quality of care. The other thing though is I knew most people that came into the zoo had no idea that there was a vet team working behind the scenes. And I wanted that to change. I wanted people to be able to come in and get inspired by what we do, see the care that's actually going into these animals. And that way, every visitor has a chance to be aware of all the amazing things that are taking place behind the scenes.
What has been your most memorable moment in the operation room?
Oh goodness, there's so many. We've had a ton, but probably, you know, those moments that you think things are going smooth and then they don't. You know, we've had animals, well, you know, where you think that we've got them in good plane of anesthesia and then they decide that, hey, they're not. Today, I was examining a little lizard and the keeper had him and then jumped right at my face. So that stuff happens all the time. You just prepare for it. Also, you know, when we're on show at the hospital, so anybody can watch us, which is great. But also when you have bloopers happen that you really didn't want others to see. Just the other day I was working on a bird and I turned a bottle of like this powder stuff that I was applying and the whole lid came off and it dumped everywhere. So I had to vacuum the bird. So quite embarrassing.
So what is your favorite aspect of your job?
Oh, I love raising the babies. The vet team assists with hand-rearing babies when moms can't. I've helped raise just about every clouded leopard that's been born here, and you know, everything from small little mammals up to big calves. So it's super fun to be a part of those babies and seeing them grow up.
Do you have any advice that you would like to give anybody who's looking to go into animal care?
Good grades, math and science is always important, but also getting a lot of experience. So help out at animal shelters, go work at the wildlife center in your backyard, help take care of babies. I mean, the hand-rearing experience that I have is because I worked at wildlife centers. It's not because of veterinary school. So really, it's just getting experience, meeting people, making connections. It's always really important.
And how can the Nashville residents help just from their own home?
You know, spreading the news about us, sharing things that we've got events going on, that things are happening here at the zoo. And then of course, just coming, being a member is a great way. It's a cost-effective way, but it also helps our revenue. Clicking and liking all of our stuff, and then following all of our conservation efforts and sharing it with their friends, and then also doing stuff at home, you know, to help the planet. It can be beyond just helping Nashville Zoo. So, you know, saying no to palm oil and, you know, decreasing their energy use, those things. So there's a whole bunch of ways that all the people that live in Nashville can help us out.
Thank you so much for sitting down with me today. I've learned so much, and I'm so excited to bring my family and friends back to the zoo.